What's up, guys? So, if you guys want to see how I got this colorful look with the Jaclyn Hill palette, keep watching, stay tuned, and let's get right into the video. All right, guys, so let's start off with this beautiful makeup right here. All right, so let's go right ahead and take the Jaclyn Hill palette. Right into that color, and it's super pigmented, guys. We're gonna do that same thing that we always do, go into the crease and then go on the outer corner. You guys, this shade is super pigmented, so I did go in a little bit because, you know, it's always better to build up opposed to just go right on and packing that damn color on. I wanted to play with some color. I mean, look how gorgeous that's it. Like, this is just so pretty. I don't know, I just wanted to play with that blue color. It inspired me, so yeah. You wanna make sure to go in the inner corner a little bit as well. So at first, I'm just gonna, you know, like, take this color and really build it up first. And then we'll go right above the crease. Just so that way it looks really seamless. Now I'm gonna go in with a lot of the eyeshadow and start blending even more. I'm just trying to build up that intensity. As you guys can see, like, look how more intense that shit is. You guys, it's gonna look weird at first, but you know, after the cut crease and everything, then it will start coming together a little bit more. Alright, so as you guys can see, it looks very harsh, right? So we're gonna go in with another clean one. These brushes are both the same. They are both from Morphe. The M514, this one I'm using to really pack on that color and get it where I want. Then we're gonna be taking this shade right here, that one, which is in Creamsicle, and I'm gonna take a little bit of that one and start fading this into the top, just so I can start blending just a little bit more. So we're gonna go ahead and grab the Anastasia highlighter from Amarizzi. And we're gonna be taking this color right here on a detailed brush. This is the M508. We're gonna go right along the highest point of that brow and dragging it across front to back, just like that. I'm gonna be taking Tarte Shape Tape a little bit, putting it on the back of my hand, and then we're going to start carving out that crease right there. Alright, guys, so now that we did that cut crease, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna grab this palette. This is the Tarte in Bloom, and I'm gonna be just using this cream shade right here. It's called Flower Child, and I'm gonna be setting that lid space just because I want it to be very clean and like an off-white color. I don't really want that much of a color on it, really. So just like that. And now, guys, so what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be taking a little bit of glitter glue. This one is from NYX, and it's just their glitter glue. We're gonna put some on the back of my hand right here, and then I'm gonna be taking the Dose of Colors angled brush to really define that crease. And then to set that glitter glue, we're gonna be using this NYX glitter. This one is a like silver iridescent. As you guys can see, it's in the crease right now. Just like that, and then I'm gonna dip right on top of that lid, go right ahead on top and start setting that glitter glue. So this is like the adhesive for the glitter, guys, obviously. But I know there will be people asking in the comments, like, what did you use? So just like that, guys. Now we're gonna be taking that blue shade again and go right over it just to mesh all of it together. We're gonna be taking the NYX matte liquid liner and just draw a line across so that when we apply these falsies that they hide really good. By taking a little bit of our full coverage stick. This one is from Craylon. Okay, so this is the TV paint stick, and the reason why I'm using this one is to show you guys how full coverage this is. Like, this is like look at that. Was I had facial hair and now I don't. Where did it go? No, but I love this TV paint stick from this one is from Craylon. You guys know a lot of like drag queens use this. It is a really drag queen kind of foundation, because it's like ridiculous, like on how full coverage it really is, like redonkulous, guys. So I'm gonna go ahead and use my Morphe E7, spray a little bit of that Morphe spray on it. So as you guys can see, it's like my perfect shade. That's why I love to use this, guys. It's like my perfect shade. And you guys, I just grabbed them. I got this one at Namie's and it's like super beautiful. All right, guys, so now let's highlight the forehead a little bit. All right, guys, so now let's grab our sponge and start blending. Like, as you guys can see, look how full coverage that shit is. So you guys already know, in my last video, I'm gonna do the same damn steps. I'm just gonna be taking my LA Girl Pro finishing powder, and gonna go in with a kabuki brush just like this and start setting the cheek area, just so that way when we go ahead and put bronzer, it's gonna blend like a dream. And then we're gonna sweep all of that bakage underneath our eye out. So now let's go right in with some bronzer, guys. I'm trying to hurry up because I don't have no more time on my camera. And I don't want to delete nothing, so I'm trying to hurry. So I'm just going to bronze up a little bit. I like to look a little bit more orangey. That's just my preference.
Access.
So we're gonna be taking the Reezy highlighter. Look at how gorge that is. Okay, so let's start highlighting to the golds. Especially because. Just like that, guys. Down the bridge of the nose a little bit on the Cupid's bow. I'm not gonna do that much, guys, just because the eyes are already so much, you know what I mean? El Yelly Bean. So we're using the Brunch Liquid Lip from Morphe. Put that one on. I just really wanted to go really nude because I feel like you can't really do anything other than a nude. We're gonna be taking this a really blue mermaid color. We're gonna be putting that into the inner corner, and then on top of that, we're gonna be going in with the Amrezy shade. So we're gonna be taking that Amrezy shade and putting that on top. The reason why I like it's gonna make it really bright and turquoise. That's why. So as you guys can see, look at it really toned that down, but basically just like that, guys, and then it just brightened it up even more. So that's pretty much it. So I hope you guys like this video. Please like and comment and subscribe. Share this video with everybody, guys. I really like it because it's like very colorful. So if you guys wanted to use the Jaclyn Hill palette, you guys can definitely use this palette and use all of these colorful shades in them. That's pretty much it. So I hope you guys liked it. Please like, comment, and subscribe, like I said, and I'll see you guys in my next video.